is the translation of the message which was read out in the first satsang. This is a message which Sanji has given to all the dear ones. Understand the feelings of my heart, appreciate it. Dear children of true lords, Hazur, Sawan and Kripal, in the holy name and in the true and pure remembrance of my great master, many greetings to all of you on the happy occasion of the new year. I wish that the new year may be filled with all the happiness for all of you, and you may always be on the path of progress. Dear ones, all the rishis and munis, masters and prophets, in their own times and in their own languages and words, have warned us, have cautioned us, that we do not know when and from where the hawk of death may come and snatch us away. He doesn't care if one is big or small, woman or man, rich or poor, white or black, whether one is from the east or the west. Once he comes, he cannot be postponed. He doesn't fear anyone. He does not spare anyone. He does not give any concession to anyone. In fact, he is very punctual, and after coming at the exact time, he shows us his face. He takes our life away with him while we are still crying, screaming and pleading. It is said in Gurubani, neither any king nor any lord remains, nor any pauper or fakir. Everyone goes as per his turn. No one consoles anyone. In his satsangs, Supreme Father Kripal Singh Ji, while mentioning the death, usually used to recite this couplet in Urdu. No one is aware of his death. No one knows about one moment, but is collecting things for a century. It means that we, the forgetful jivas, have forgotten the death, and forgetting it, we are collecting the materials for the centuries, even though we do not know whether the next breath will come or not. True Lord Sawan used to say that the amazing thing is that we ourselves carrying our relatives and friends to the cremation ground, consign them to the fire, but never we have made our cunning and foolish mind realize and understand that such a day has to come to us also. And one day, all of a sudden, we will have to leave the market of this world. We are not aware of that moment. Gurubani says, open your eyes up and see where are your friends and brothers. One is going, one will go. Everyone goes on his turn. Sufi Saint Farid Sahib says that the bones break and one feels pain at the time of death. Poor soul is taken out by breaking the bones. Kabir Sahib explains, when the pranas are separated from the body, the ghosts call him near. No one keeps him even for half a moment. He is thrown out of home. He has also written, one's wife, whom one loved so much and who always lived with him, even she runs away saying, ghost, ghost, when the hansa, the soul, abandons the body. Bhagat Namdev Ji has drawn the picture of this moment like this. He says, Duryodhan and his 100 brothers used to say, mine, mine. Their kingdom extended to a long distance. But when they died, not even the vultures ate their bodies. Ravana was very mighty. His kingdom of Lanka was made of gold. And at his door, the elephants were tied. But in one moment, everything became someone else's. The words of the saints are very clear. They don't leave any illusion. Guru Nanak Sahib has said that, O dear ones, don't think that the death will come after asking the astrologer the appropriate date and time. He has said that the death does not ask for the auspicious occasion, neither it asks for the date and day. He has bundled up one, he is bundling up another, and all will be beaten up. He even made it clear that do not think that the death stings only the poor ones and spares the kings and the emperors. No, brothers, his sting is the same for all. We have seen the sultans being reduced to ashes. Nanak says everyone goes breaking the love with the falsehood. So, dear children, as I send you the greetings with much happiness and enthusiasm, I also, in much emphatic words and with hearty feelings and love, want to tell you that come to senses and work with wisdom. Wake up from the deep slumber of attachment, maya and ignorance. Open up your eyes, understand the truth, recognize the death as the truth and life as false. Collect that wealth which may help you at the end time and which may go with us while departing from this world. As you all know that all the saints have told us the importance of human body. They have said that only in this body can we meet with Lord Almighty. The other bodies have not been given this privilege. Kabir Sahib has explained the glory of the human birth and have tried to explain to us the work, which is the most important one and which cannot be done in any other body, by saying this. He says, the body which is craved for even by the gods is the body through which one can devote himself to God Almighty. Remember God Almighty, do not forget, as this is the only advantage you can take of this human birth. Guru Arjan Dev Ji says, the best body among the 84 legs of creation is the human body. God Almighty has given it the glory. He who misses on this step comes and goes and suffers the miseries. At another place, Guru Sahib says, you have got the human body. This is the only opportunity you have to meet with Lord Almighty. All other works are of no use. Meeting with Sat Sangat, meditate only upon Naam. Dear children, all this I always tell you in the satsangs, but today I am repeating this in more powerful words so that you may listen to this with much attention, understand it, and start following it from today itself. Dear ones, understand the feelings of my heart and appreciate it. Make my words part of your life. Devote more and more time in meditation so that I may get some comfort. I may get helped in performing the duty which my great master has given to me. May the burden be lessened and may you receive the grace and pleasure of both the great masters. Dear ones, this time will not come again. Once you lose this, you will repent and cry. What more can I say to make you understand? Listen to the plea which is coming out from the depth of my heart. Understand me, and from today itself, or rather from this moment on, apply yourself to bhajan and simran with all your strength. If our earnings are pure, life is clean, and if we have faith in the master, our meditation will flourish soon. So come, let us attack and march towards the court of the master and earn his pleasure and make our this life and the life beyond worth it. The wiper of your shoes, Ajayab Singh.
परम पिता परमात्मा सावन कृपाल दे चरणां दे विच नमस्कार है जिन्हां ने साडे गरीब आत्मा ते रहम करके आपदा जश करन दा मौका दिता है.
Salutations unto the feet of Supreme Fathers, Lord Almighty, Savan and Kripal, who having mercy on the poor souls have given us the opportunity to sing their glory.
ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦਾ ਛੋਟਾ ਜਿਹਾ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਰੱਖਿਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ, ਗੌਰ ਨਾਲ ਸੁਣਨਾ ਹੈ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਸੰਤਾਂ ਦੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਅਨਭਵੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਜੋ ਕੁਛ ਉਹ ਬਿਆਨ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੈ ਅੱਖੀਂ ਦੇਖ ਕੇ ਉਹ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੈ. ਵੈਸੇ ਸੰਤਾਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਨਹੀਂ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਗਏ ਕਿ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਅਸੀਂ ਅਭਿਆਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਫਸਾਈਏ, ਕੋਲੂ ਦੀ ਬੈਲ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਇਹ ਰੋਜ਼ ਹੀ ਤੁਰੇ ਫਿਰਨ, ਲੇਕਿਨ ਜਦ ਅਸੀਂ ਭੁੱਲੜ ਜੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਉਪਦੇਸ਼ ਨੂੰ ਦੂਸਰੇ ਨੰਬਰ 'ਤੇ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਪਹਿਲੇ ਨੰਬਰ 'ਤੇ ਦੁਨੀਆਦਾਰੀ ਰੱਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ, ਉਦੋਂ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਾਰੀਆਂ ਮਿਸਾਲਾਂ ਦੇ ਦੇ ਕੇ ਸਮਝਾਉਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਮ ਸੇ ਕਮ ਇਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਤਾਂ ਇਹ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਸਾਡੀ ਸਮਝ ਆਉਣਗੇ. ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਮਕਸਦ ਇਤਨਾ ਹੀ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਸਾਡੇ ਭੁੱਲੇ ਆਤਮਾ ਦੇ ਘਰ ਦੀ ਦੱਸ ਪਾਉਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ.
A brief hymn of Kabir Sahib is presented to you and it should be listened to with much attention. Because the words of the masters are their experience, they speak out of their experience and they do not mean to keep us involved in doing the meditations, just like the bullock of the oil mill is tied and he goes round and round just churning the mill. Masters do not mean that we should always go and bring the meditation. But when we do not understand the words of the Master and when we do not give the priority to the meditation, and when we bring it on the second number and when we give the priority to the worldly things, then the Masters, in order to make our forgetful minds understand, give us various different examples of this world, hoping that if not by this example, maybe by some other example, we will come around and we will understand and we will do the work for which the Masters have come in this world.
ਮੈਂ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਹੀ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਦਿੰਦਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਫੇਰ ਅੱਜ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਇਹ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਨਾਲ ਉਹ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਬੜੀ ਹੀ ਅੱਛੀ ਟੁੱਕਦੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਿਸੇ ਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਖਾਨਾ ਬਦੋਸ਼ ਉਠਾ ਕੇ ਲੈ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਪਿਤਾ ਦੇ ਦਿਲ ਅੰਦਰ ਮਮਤਾ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਆਪਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਚਿਕਰ ਭਾਲ ਨਾ ਲਵੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਸ਼ਾਂਤੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਂਦੀ ਗੀ ਔਰ ਉਹ ਖਾਨਾ ਬਦੋਸ਼ਾਂ ਦੀ ਜਦੋਂ ਰੋਜ਼ ਸੰਗਤ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਸੋਭਤ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਉਹ ਭਾਸ਼ਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਲੈਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਉਹ ਬੋਲੀ ਸਿੱਖ ਲੈਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹੋ ਜਿਹੇ ਉਹ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਪਹਿਨਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਸਾ ਹੀ ਉਹ ਕਾਰਿਕ੍ਰਮ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਖੁਸ਼ ਹੈ ਲੇਕਿਨ ਪਿਤਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਇਹਦਾ ਘਰ ਦੱਸਾਂ ਕਿ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਭੁੱਲਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੈ ਖਾਨਾ ਬਦੋਸ਼ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਦਾ ਅੱਜ ਘਰ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੈ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਨੂੰ ਹੋਰ ਕਿਤੇ ਹੈ ਸੋ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਹੌਲੀ ਹੌਲੀ ਉਹਦੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਮਿੱਠੀਆਂ ਮਿੱਠੀਆਂ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਪਿਆਰ ਭਰੀਆਂ ਸੁਣਾ ਕੇ ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਦੇ ਸੰਪਰਕ 'ਚ ਲਿਆਉਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਉਹਦਾ ਘਰ ਦਿਖਾ ਦੇਵਾਂ ਕਿ ਤੇਰਾ ਆਹ ਘਰ ਹੈ ਤੂੰ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦੇ ਰਹਿਣ ਵਾਲਾ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਕਾਲ ਤੈਨੂੰ ਚੁੱਕ ਲਿਆਇਆ ਹੈ ਇਹਨੇ ਸਤਪੁਰਸ਼ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਇਸ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇਸ ਦੁਨੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੋ ਅਗਰ ਜੇ ਤੂੰ ਮੇਰੇ ਕਹਿਣ ਦੇ ਮੁਤਾਬਕ ਅੰਦਰ ਜਾਵੇਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਪਛਾਣੇ ਆਪ ਦਾ ਘਰ ਪਛਾਣੇ ਕਿ ਕਿਹੜਾ ਹੈ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਬੱਚਾ ਵਾਪਸ ਆਪਣੇ ਘਰ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਹੈ ਸਚਿਆਈ ਕੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਾਲ ਨੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਅਨੁਰਾਗ ਸਾਗਰ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਹੋ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਤਪੱਛਿਆ ਕਰਕੇ ਆਤਮਾ ਮੰਗ ਲਈਆਂ ਉਹ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਨੇ ਦੇ ਦਿੱਤੀਆਂ ਲੇਕਿਨ ਇਹ ਵੀ ਇੱਕ ਇਕਰਾਰ ਹੋਇਆ ਕਿ ਜੋ ਆਤਮਾ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਮਿਲਣ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਤੜਫੇਗੀ ਜੋ ਮੇਰੇ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਹੀ ਦਿਨ ਰਾਤ ਇੰਤਜ਼ਾਰ ਕਰੇਗੀ ਮੈਂ ਆਪਦੇ ਘਰ ਕਦੋਂ ਪਹੁੰਚਾਂ ਮੈਂ ਖੁਦ ਹੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਪਾਸ ਜਾਊਂਗਾ ਔਰ ਬਾਂਹ ਪਕੜ ਕੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਲੈ ਜਾਊਂਗਾ
I have always given this example but this example implies more with this particular hymn of Kabir Sahib which is presented to you and that is why I will say this again it's like that if someone's son is kidnapped by the gypsies and he is taken away that boy does not remember his home he lives with the gypsies but because the father has the love and the attachment for the child that is why he goes after the child but he is living with the gypsies he is eating like the gypsies he is dressed up like the gypsies and he likes to do all the things with the gypsies do and he does not remember that where he belongs who is his father and where is his home so but he wants that his son should come back to home so what he does he goes and talk to him sweetly and he tells him about his home and gradually when the child spends the time in the company of his father then he comes to realize that he does not belong to the gypsies he is not one of them he is different than them and in that process sometime somehow the father wishes and he becomes successful in taking him to his home and showing him that this is where he belongs this is a real home so lovingly the father tells the child that dear one you were taken away you were kidnapped by the gypsies this is not your home your home is somewhere else and you do not belong to them so later on when the child is convinced he agrees to go with the father and in the end he returns to his original home to his real father this is just an example but what is the reality as we have read in the Anurag Sagar that how negative power did the seva of the satpurush and in return he got the souls to develop his own place and how at that time all the souls were given to the negative power but at that time this agreement was also made that if any soul would want to come back to the real home and if anyone would remain in the remembrance of God Almighty then God Almighty himself would come down in the form of the saints and he himself would find for that, search for that soul, and he himself would inspire that soul and bring him back to the real home.
ਪਿਆਰਿਓ ਜਦ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਆਤਮਾ ਸਾਡੀ ਉਹ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਤੋਂ ਵਿਛੜੀ ਹੈ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਇਸ ਨੇ ਕਿਤਨੀਆਂ ਝੋਪੜੀਆਂ ਮਹੱਲ ਬਣਾਏ ਹੈ ਸਦਾ ਉੱਥੇ ਰਹਿ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਕੀ ਵਕਤ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਉਹਦੇ ਮਾਲਕ ਕੋਈ ਹੋਰ ਬਣ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਆਤਮਾ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਬਿਸਤਰ ਝਾੜ ਕੇ ਕਿਸੇ ਹੋਰ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਘਰ ਬਣਾਉਣਾ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ
ਡੀਅਰ ਵਨਸ ਐਵਰ ਸਿੰਸ ਅਵਰ ਸੋਲ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬੀਨ ਸੈਪਰੇਟਡ ਫਰੋਮ ਗੋਡ ਆਲਮਾਈਟੀ ਵੀ ਡੂ ਨਾਟ ਨੋ ਦੈਟ ਹਾਊ ਮੈਨੀ ਟਾਈਮਸ ਹਾਊ ਮੈਨੀ ਹਰਟਸ ਐਂਡ ਪੈਲੇਸਿਸ ਐਂਡ ਬਿਲਡਿੰਗਸ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਮੇਡ ਬਟ ਨੈਵਰ ਅਵਰ ਸੋਲ ਹੈਜ਼ ਬੀਨ ਏਬਲ ਟੂ ਰਿਮੇਨ ਔਰ ਲਿਵ ਇਨ ਦੈਟ ਇਨ ਦੋਜ਼ ਪਲੇਸਿਸ ਫੋਰ ਐਵਰ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਸ਼ੀ ਹੈਜ਼ ਟੂ ਲੀਵ ਦੈਟ ਪਲੇਸ ਐਮਪਟੀ ਹੈਂਡਡ ਐਂਡ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਦੈਰ ਇਜ਼ ਸਮਵਨ ਐਲਸ ਹੂ ਕਮਸ ਐਂਡ ਬਿਕਮਸ ਦੀ ਓਨਰ ਆਫ ਦ ਪਲੇਸਿਸ
ਇੱਕ ਦੁਨਿਆਵੀ ਪਿਤਾ ਦੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਇਤਨੀ ਮਮਤਾ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਆਪਦੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਨੂੰ ਉਦੋਂ ਹੀ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਬਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਜਦੋਂ ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਪਾਲ ਲੈਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਲੇਕਿਨ ਜਿਸ ਦੀ ਇਹ ਅੰਸ ਹੈ ਜਿਸ ਦੀ ਇਹ ਬੱਚੀ ਹੈ ਆਤਮਾ ਉਸ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਦੇ ਦਿਲ ਅੰਦਰ ਕਿਤਨਾ ਪਿਆਰ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਖੁਦ ਹੀ ਖਾਨਾ ਬਦੋਸ਼ਾਂ ਦੇ ਜੈਸੇ ਕੱਪੜੇ ਪਾਏ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਹੈ ਜੈਸੇ ਉਹ ਭਾਸ਼ਾ ਬੋਲਦੇ ਹੈ ਉਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦਾ ਉਹ ਸਵਾਂਗ ਬਣਾ ਕੇ ਰਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਬੱਚਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੈ ਉਹਦੀ ਬਾਤ ਨੂੰ ਸੁਣਨ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਤਿਆਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਮੰਨਣਾ ਤਾਂ ਕੀ ਸੀਗਾ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਬੜੀ ਬੜੀ ਚੋਟੀ ਦੇ ਮਹਾਤਮਾ ਇਸ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਏ ਲੇਕਿਨ ਅਸੀਂ ਭੁੱਲੜ ਜੀਵਾਂ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਤਾਂ ਕੀ ਉਠਾਉਣਾ ਸੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤਿਆਰ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਵਾਪਸ ਆਪਣੇ ਘਰ ਸੱਚਖੰਡ ਤੱਕ ਕੀ ਪਹੁੰਚਣਾ ਸੀ ਬਲਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਅਸੀਂ ਤਕਲੀਫਾਂ ਦਿੱਤੀਆਂ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਆਰਿਆਂ ਨਾਲ ਚਰਾ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਜਿੰਦੇ ਜੀਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਤੱਤਿਆਂ ਤਵਾਂ 'ਤੇ ਬਿਠਾ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਲੇਕਿਨ ਕਦੇ ਉਸ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਦੇ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਬਦਲੇ ਕਦੇ ਬਦਦੁਆ ਨਹੀਂ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਇਹ ਜ਼ਰੂਰ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਹੇ ਪਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਤੂੰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਬਖਸ਼ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ
ਅ ਵਰਲਡਲੀ ਫਾਦਰ ਹੈਜ਼ ਸੋ ਮਚ ਲਵ ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਅਟੈਚਮੈਂਟ ਫਾਰ ਦ ਚਾਈਲਡ ਦੈਟ ਹੀ ਡਜ਼ ਨਾਟ ਫੀਲ peace and he does not rest unless he is able to trace his son and unless he is able to bring his back to his real home. Just imagine how much love our true father God Almighty has for us. He comes and he lives among the gypsies and he dresses up like the gypsies, he does everything like the gypsies and he tells us about our real home but we are not ready to even listen to him. The least we can do is go with him. We don't even want to listen to him. But he has so much love for us, he has so much attachment for us, and he gives us so much of the comfort, and he comes and lives in this world which is full of sufferings for our sake, and we don't want to listen to him. What to talk about taking advantage of his coming and going back to our real home? We even torture them, we give them hard time. Many great masters, the masters of the highest orders have come in this world, but how we the worldly people have bothered them. We made them sit on the hot coals, we cut their bodies with the saw, and in that way, in many different ways, we torture them. But never those great masters who came in this world to take our soul back to the real home have ever cursed the soul. In fact, they always pray to God Almighty, they always ask for the forgiveness for those souls, those who become the cause of their suffering, those who torture them. From God Almighty by saying that, oh Lord, they do not know what they are doing, so you kindly forgive them.
ਜਿਸ ਮਹਾਤਮਾ ਦਾ ਆਪਾਂ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਲਿਆ ਹੈ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੀ ਹਿਸਟਰੀ ਪੜ੍ਹਦੇ ਹੋ ਉਸ ਵਕਤ ਦੇ ਮਜ਼੍ਹਬੀ ਕੱਟੜਪੁਣੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਜੋ ਸਨ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਿਤਨੇ ਯਤਨ ਕੀਤੇ ਅੱਗ 'ਚ ਖੜਾ ਕਰਿਆ ਹੱਥ ਪੈਰ ਬੰਨ ਕੇ ਦਰਿਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਗੰਗਾ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰੋੜ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਹਾਥੀ ਨੂੰ ਸ਼ਰਾਬ ਪਿਆ ਕੇ ਮਸਤ ਦੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਵੀ ਸੁੱਟ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਉਦੋਂ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਾਂ ਹੱਥ ਪੈਰ ਬੰਨੇ ਹੋਏ ਸੀਗੇ
ਦ ਮਹਾਤਮਾ ਹੁਜ਼ ਬਾਨੀ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਟੇਕਿੰਗ ਟੂਡੇ how he was also given a very hard time by the religious people in his time, that how once he was made to stand in the fire and how his hands and feet were tied and he was thrown in the water of river Ganges, and how after making the elephant drink the wine and after making him intoxicated he was thrown in the form of the bundle, his hands and feet were tied and he was thrown in front of that intoxicated drunk elephant.
ਹਾਥੀ ਦੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਗੱਠੜੀ ਬੰਨ ਕੇ ਜਦ ਸਿੱਟਿਆ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਖੁਦ ਉਸ ਦਾ ਜ਼ਿਕਰ ਆਪਣੀ ਬਾਣੀ 'ਚ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੈ ਕਿਆ ਉਪਰਾਧ ਸੰਤ ਹੈ ਕੀਨਾ ਬਾਂਧ ਪੋਟ ਕੁੰਚਰ ਕੋ ਦੀਨਾ ਕੁੰਚਰ ਪੋਟ ਲੈ ਲੈ ਨਿਮਸ਼ਕਾਰ ਹੈ ਬੂਝੈ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਾਜੀ ਅੰਧਿਆਰਾ ਹੈ
ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਹਿਮਸੈਲਫ ਡਿਸਕ੍ਰਾਈਬਸ ਦ ਟਾਈਮ ਵੈਨ ਹੀ ਵਾਸ ਥਰੋਨ ਇਨ ਫਰੰਟ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਡਰੰਕ ਐਲੀਫੈਂਟ ਇਨ ਦ ਫਾਰਮ ਆਫ ਅ ਬੰਡਲ ਹੀ ਸੇਜ਼ that tying up my hands and feet and making me like a bundle, I was thrown in front of the elephant. But the elephant, instead of crushing me, he came and he bowed down at me. He went on bowing down at me, but the Kaji did not understand that what is the glory, what is the story behind that.
ਆਏ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਕਦਰ ਨਾ ਕਰਦੇ ਮੱਥੇ ਟੇਕਣ ਮੜੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਜਦੋਂ ਤਾਂ ਮਾਲਕ ਦੇ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਉਦੋਂ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਕਦਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਗੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਗੈਰ ਮਨੁੱਖੀ ਤਸੀਹੇ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਹੈ ਜਦੋਂ ਮਾਲਕ ਦੇ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਚਲੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੀ ਰੋਜ਼ੀ ਰੋਟੀ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਬਣਾ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸੋਚ ਕੇ ਦੇਖ ਲਓ ਜਦ ਜਿਉਂਦੇ ਦੀ ਕਦਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤੀ ਗਈ ਜਦੇ ਗਏ ਸੰਸਾਰ ਤੋਂ ਫਿਰ ਕੀ ਕਦਰ ਕਰਨੀ ਸੀ ਅੱਜ ਇਸੇ ਮਹਾਤਮਾ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੇ ਕਈ ਚੌਂਕਾਂ ਦਾ ਨਾਮ ਰੱਖਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੈ ਸੰਤ ਕਬੀਰ ਚੌਕ ਹੈ ਕਿਸੇ ਸੜਕ ਦਾ ਨਾਂ ਰੱਖਿਆ ਹੋਇਆ ਹੈ ਅੱਜ ਲੋਕ ਜਿੰਨੀ ਕਦਰ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੈ ਅਗਰ ਉਸ ਵਕਤ ਵੀ ਜਦੋਂ ਸਰੀਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਨ ਮਦਦ ਕਰਦੇ ਤਾਂ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ
ਵੀ ਡੂ ਨਾਟ ਐਪਰੀਸ਼ੀਏਟ ਦਾ ਮਾਸਟਰਸ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਕਮ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਬਟ ਆਫਟਰ ਦੇ ਲੀਵ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਵੀ ਮੇਕ ਦਾ ਟੂਮਸ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਮੈਮੋਰੀਅਲਸ ਇਨ ਦੇਅਰ ਮੈਮਰੀ ਐਂਡ ਇਨ ਦੈਟ ਵੇ ਵੀ ਸ਼ੋ ਦੈਟ ਵੀ ਐਪਰੀਸ਼ੀਏਟ ਦੈਮ ਬਟ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਕੇਮ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਵੀ ਡਿਡ ਨਾਟ ਲਿਸਨ ਟੂ ਦੈਮ ਵੀ ਡਿਡ ਨਾਟ ਐਪਰੀਸ਼ੀਏਟ ਦੈਮ ਐਂਡ ਵੀ ਡਿਡ ਨਾਟ ਟੇਕ ਐਨੀ ਐਡਵਾਂਟੇਜ ਆਫ ਦੈਮ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ when he came he was also not appreciated and after he left now there are many squares and many roads many streets which are named after him so when the masters come in this world people do not appreciate them and after they leave for their own benefit for their own business we set up the memorials we make the tombs and the places like that and in that we say that we are doing the appreciation or we appreciate the master if Like when Kabir Sahib came, if people had appreciated him at that time, they would have taken a lot of advantage of his coming.
Chetavani aur Upadesh, Shabd Pehla, Kabir Sahib ki Shabdavali, Bhag Pehla, Panna number 19. Bin Sat Gur Nar Rehet Pulana जत फिरत राह नहीं जाना बिन सत गुर नर रहत पुलाना खोजत फिरत राह नहीं जाना
ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਦੀ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਜ਼ਰੂਰਤ ਪੈਂਦੀ ਹੈ ਜਿਸ ਮੰਜ਼ਿਲ 'ਤੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਅਗਰ ਸਾਡੇ ਪਾਸ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਨਕਸ਼ਾ ਹੈ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਦਾ ਕੋਈ ਪਾਂਧੀ ਨਾਲ ਹੈ ਅਸੀਂ ਨਕਸ਼ੇ ਨੂੰ ਦੇ ਕੇ ਵੀ ਤਸੱਲੀ ਕਰਦੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਤਜਰਬੇਕਾਰ ਤੋਂ ਵੀ ਫਾਇਦਾ ਉਠਾ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹੈ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਵੀ ਦੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਈ ਵਾਰੀ ਰੋਜ਼ ਲੰਘਦੇ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਪਿਆਰੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੈਰ ਪੈਰ ਤੇ ਭੁੱਲਣ ਦਾ ਡਰ ਰਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਸ ਰਸਤੇ ਦੇ ਵਾਕਫ ਹੋਈਏ ਗਾਈਡ ਸਾਡੇ ਸਾਥ ਹੋਵੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਕਾਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਬੇਝਿਜਕ ਹੋ ਕੇ ਦੌੜਾਈ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ
ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸੇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਈਵਨ ਇਨ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਵੀ ਨੀਡ ਅ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਸਪੋਜ਼ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਰੀਚ ਐਨੀ ਪਲੇਸ ਐਨੀ ਡੈਸਟੀਨੇਸ਼ਨ Either we have the map of that place or if we have someone who has been to that place, if we have a co-traveler, only then it becomes easier for us. There is always a danger and there is always a possibility of losing our way even in the place which we have traveled many times. But if we know someone, if we know that way and if we have someone who has been on that way and who can guide us, then without any hesitation we can take our car straight to our destination.
ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਹੈ ਬਗੈਰ ਕਿਸੇ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਤੋਂ ਜੀ ਭਰਮ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਭੁੱਲਿਆ ਫਿਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਜੋ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਹੈ ਉਹਨੇ ਉਹ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਦੇਖੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਬੇਝਿਜਕ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਅਗਰ ਸਾਥ ਕਰੀਏ ਤੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਮੰਜ਼ਿਲ ਤੇ ਪਹੁੰਚ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ
ਕਬੀਰ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਸੇ ਦੈਟ ਵਿਦਆਊਟ ਦ ਗਾਈਡੈਂਸ ਜੀਵਾ ਆਲਵੇਸ ਰਿਮੇਨਸ ਇਨ ਦੀ ਇਲੂਜਨ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਆਲਵੇਸ ਫੋਰਗੈਟਿੰਗ ਬਟ ਇਫ ਦ ਗਾਈਡ knows the destination and if we have his company then without any hesitation without any difficulty in his company we can easily reach our destination
kabir sahib kehnde hai ke odro koi na aaya jaate puchu taaye idro sab koi jaat hai paar ladaye ladaye
kabir sahib says that no one is coming from the other side from the beyond to whom I can go and ask him about this path everyone is going from here carrying all the burden.
दुनिया इधरों तक चंगे माड़े कर्मा दा इकट्ठे करके बोझा लेके तुरे जांदे है और उधरों कोई नहीं आया। अगे कबीर साहब कहंदे उधरों सतगुर आया जाते पुछू ताए। उस दुनिया दे विचो पूर्ण महात्मा आया है, मैं उस नूं पुछदा है अगर वो मेरी जिम्मेवारी उठाउंदा है, मेरे नाल सफर करदा है, मैनू कराउंदा है, मैं जाते पुछू ताए।
द वर्ल्ड carrying the burden of the good and bad karmas which they have done and which they have collected is going from this side, but no one is coming from the other side. Kabir Sahib further says that from the other side, from the beyond, only the Sadguru comes. Let me run to him and ask him if he would take up my responsibility upon him, if he would take my responsibility upon him, if he would be my co-traveler, if he would be my guide, and if he would take me along with him in the world beyond.
Kabir Sahib kende hai Ram Krishna ko bade tinho ke gur keen teen log ke nah ka gur age adheen.
Kabir Sahib said that who were greater than Rama and Krishna? They were the owners of the three worlds, but even they surrendered to their masters.
Bin sat gur nar rehet pulana khojat firat raah ne jana ke har sut le aayo gadariya पाल पोसे उन कीन से आना कारत कलोल रहते अजयन संग आपन मरम उन्हों ने जाना।
थोड़ा प्यार ना मसाल दे के कहंदे है कि जिस तरह शेर दे बच्चे नू कोई भेड़ा दा उजाड़ी लाया हुंदा है, ओनू भेड़ा दा दुध पला पला के वड्डा कर लेंदा है, वो भेड़ा दे बच्चियां नाल रोज खेलदा है, कदे वो ओदी पिठ ते चढ़दे है, कदे वो चढ़दा है, बड़ा है मौज मस्ती दे विच है, लेकिन अपने आप दा ओनू पता नहीं कि मैं शेर है या भेड़ है।
Now lovingly giving us the example, Kabir Sahib tells us that just like a shepherd brings a cub of a tiger and rears him up, brings him up along with the baby sheep, he plays with the sheep, sometimes he gets on the back of the sheep, sometimes the sheep get on the back of the baby tiger, he does not realize that he is not the sheep, he is the tiger.
कारत कलोल रहते अजयन संग आपन मारम उन्होंने जाना के हर एक जंगल से आयो ताहे देख बहुत
एक शेर जंगल दे विचो आया। जदो उसने देखा कि शेर दा बच्चा होके भेड़ा दे विच फिरदा है, इन्हां दे नाल ही है बोझा ढोंदा फिरदा है।
One tiger came from the forest and he saw that this baby tiger, this cub of the tiger is with the sheep and like them he is also carrying the burden.
के हर एक जंगल से आयो ताहे देख बहुत तैर से आना पकड़ के पेद तुरत समझाया आपन दशा देख मुस्क्याना।
वो केहर कहने लग गया तू पेड़ नहीं जो तू बोली बोलना है इन्हें खुश होना है, तू शेर का बच्चा है, तू शेर है, लेकिन वो शेर का बच्चा जड़ा सीगा वो मनन वास्ते तैयार नहीं गए। फिर वो की कहंदा है कि देख भी प्यारिया आ तू मेरे नाल, आपा पानी ते कुए ते खड़िए, तू वेख आपदी शकल तू कौन है। जो ने अपनी शकल देखी बड़ा ही दिल दे विच अचरज हुंदा है कि मेरे नाल की होया, ये मैं भेड़ा दे विच मैनू कौन लिया है, मैं क्यों रहना है, मैं इन्हां दी बोली क्यों सिखिया है, मेरी तो बड़ी उच्ची जात है, उच्ची मेरी कुल है।
The tiger tells that baby tiger that you are living among, you are living with the sheep, but you are not like them, you are not the sheep. You speak their language, but your language is different, you are not the sheep. But the baby tiger did not want to believe that. So the tiger took him to the water and he made him see his own reflection, his own image. And when the baby tiger saw that he looked like the tiger and he was not like the sheep, then he realized that he was different than the sheep, and then he was surprised and he wondered that why this has happened to me, who brought me here and who made me live with them. I do not belong to them, I belong to some higher community, I belong to some higher kind of species, and I am not like the sheep with whom I was living.
कर के पेद तुरत समझाया आपन दशा देख मुस्क्याना जस को रंग बिच बसत बासना खोजत मूड फिरत चौगाना।
कबीर साहब दा उतनिया लाइना नू समझाउण दा भाव इतना ही है कि साडी आत्मा ओ परमात्मा दी बच्ची है, मन जो है ए अजाड़ी है, और भेड़ा इंद्रिया हन ए उन्हां दे विच फिर के अपने आप नू भुल चुकया है। शेर सतगुरु है जो आके प्यार नाल सानू समझाउंदा है कि अगर जे तुसी इस तरह अभ्यास करोगे, मेरे कहण ते अमल करोगे, तुसी अपना आप पछाण लोगे, और उदो फिर थानू खुद ही पता लगेगा कि की असी इस देश दे रहण वाले हैं, की असी भेड़ हैं। फिर पता लगदा है कि ओहो मैं तो आपदा जिहड़ा जन्म सी पता नहीं किन्ने बर्बाद कर दिते है, मैं तो मालिक दा रूप सी, मालिक दा बच्चा सीगा।
कबीर साहब मीन्स टू एक्सप्लेन दीज लाइन्स, बट ही मीन्स टू से इज दैट आवर सोल इज ऑफ द सेम एसेंस एज दैट ऑफ गॉड ऑलमाइटी, एंड द टाइगर इन दिस लाइन्स इज आवर सोल, and our mind is that shepherd which took away the baby tiger, which took away the cub of the tiger, and the fellow sheep, the other sheep, are the organs of senses. Now when we are living with the sheep, when our tiger, when our soul is living with the organs of the senses and with the mind, we feel that we are like them. But Sadhguru is that tiger who comes and who tells us that what is the reality, and he tells us that you are not like them, you are different, you are my essence, you are the tiger. When we listen to the Sadhguru, when we do the meditation, when we do the things which our master asked us to do, then we realize that we were not the mind, or we were not the organs of senses, we were the soul, and we were the essence of God Almighty, we were the essence of the master. And then we realize and then we repent that we have wasted many of our births, we have wasted much of our time just indulging in the pleasures of the organs of senses and obeying the mind, and it was not for us to do that. We had come in this world because we are the essence of God Almighty, and we had come in this world only to go back to our real home.
Dusri misal Kabir sahib hirn di dinde hai ki jis tarah hirn di naab de andar kasturi hundi hai, jadon kuch kasturi de vichon mehak aunda hai oh sochda hai ki te bahar hai, dur hai,
and the fragrance comes out from the navel of the deer. The deer thinks that he is smelling the fragrance which is coming from somewhere outside, and in search of that fragrance of the musk he runs outside.
Isse tarah वो परमात्मा साडे देह और वजूद दे अंदर है, असी उस दी खोज मिर्ग दी तरह बाहर भज भज के करते हैं। किथे अरब दे विच मक्का है, किथे हसन उदाल पंजा साहब है और किथे जगन्नाथ है। किन्निया किन्निया असी यात्रा लंबिया करते हैं सिर्फ कि साडा परमात्मा उथे रहिंदा है, लेकिन सानू ये नहीं पता कि वह परमात्मा साडे शरीर दे अंदर इस तरह समाया होया है जिससे मेहंदी दे अंदर पत्रां दे अंदर रंग हुंदा है, फुल दे अंदर खुशबू है और शीशे दे अंदर सुनाई है।
इन द सेम वे अवर गॉड ऑलमाइटी रिजाइड्स विद इन अवर बॉडी, बट इन सर्च फॉर हिम वी आर गोइंग टू मेनी डिफरेंट प्लेसेस, मेनी डिस्टेंट प्लेसेस। यू नो दैट हाउ फार इज मक्का इन पर्शिया एंड हाउ फार इन द प्लेस कॉल्ड हसन अब्दाल, देयर इज प्लेस कॉल्ड पंजा साहिब, एंड वी गो टू ऑल दिस प्लेसेस इन सर्च फॉर गॉड ऑलमाइटी। यू नो दैट हाउ फार इज जगन्नाथ एंड देयर आर सो मेनी अदर प्लेसेस where we go searching for God Almighty, but we do not realize that God Almighty resides within us, he is within us and he is present within our body in the way the fragrance is present in the flower, the oil is present in the seed. In the same way God Almighty resides within us.
Guru Ram Das Ji Maharaj bhi apni khoj bare dasde hai ki jo sade dil de andar tadap uthi us parmatma de paun di, असी उन्हों हर मंदिर मस्जिद धर्म स्थानां च खोजिया, इथों तक कि असी जंगलां पहाड़ां दे विच भी जाके खोज कीती, वेदां शास्त्रां दे विच भी खोज कीती, पर जदों असी गुरु अंगद देव अमरदेव जी महाराज दे चरणां विच आए, उन्हां ने कहा कि जिहदी खातर तू बाहर मारिया मारिया फिरदा है वह तो तेरे अंदर है, वह तेरी इंतजार दे विच है परमात्मा। जदों असी गुरु दे कहण दे मुताबक अंदर तवज्जो दित्ती, इन्हां अखां नाल उस परमात्मा नूं देखिया, कहण लगे कि अंतर प्यास उठी प्रभ केरी, सुन गुर बचन मन तीर लगैया। कहण लगे वह जिहड़ा बचन सीगा वह साडे तीर दी तरह लंघिया है कि मेरा परमात्मा मेरे अंदर सी, मैं इहदी खोज विच पता नहीं किन्ने जन्म भटकदा फिरिया है। शुकराना किहदा है? गुरु दा है।
Regarding his search for God Almighty, Guru Ram Das Ji Maharaj says that when the yearning to search for God Almighty was created within me, I went outside in the world searching for him. I went to different temples, the mosque and to all the other religious places, and in my search I went even into the forest and in the jungles and in the wilderness, assuming that God would be present somewhere outside in this world, in the temples, in the mosque or in the forest and jungles and like that. But after wandering so much all over the world when I could not find him, and finally when I came at the feet of my beloved master Guru Amar Das, he told me that God Almighty for whom you are searching outside is nowhere outside, he is within you. So when he told me that and when he made me see my God Almighty with my own eyes, then I came to realize, and then the words of my master pierced through my heart. He says that when within myself the yearning or the thirst for realizing God Almighty came, and when I was able to see him with my own eyes in my within according to the instructions of my master, then the words of my master pierced through my heart, and then I realized and I repented that I have wasted many of my births. I have wasted a lot of time searching for God Almighty outside, but in fact he was very much present within me.
Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj pyar na kende hai, घट ही में अमृत भरपूर है, मन मुखा साध ना पाया, ज्यों कस्तूरी मिर्ग ना जाने ओ परम दा परम परमाया।
गुरु नानक देव जी महाराज ऑल्सो सेज दैट इन योर विदिन देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ नेक्टर, योर विदिन इज फुल ऑफ द नेक्टर, बट द मनमुख्स कैन नॉट गेट इट्स अंडरस्टैंडिंग, जस्ट लाइक द डियर डज नॉट नो दैट द मस्क इज इन हिज ओन नेवर एंड वंडर्स आउटसाइड एंड ही ऑलवेज रिमेन्स इन द इल्यूजन। इन द सेम वे द मनमुख्स, इवन दो गॉड ऑलमाइटी इज विदिन देम, दे आर not able to understand him.
जस को रंग बिच बसत बासना, खोजत मूड फिरत चौगान, करे उपवास मने में देखे, ये सुगंध तो कहाँ बसाना, अरे दे औरत बिच लगन लगी है, शकियो रूप नहीं जात बखाना।
आप प्यार दे नाल दस दे है कि जद गुरु दे चरणा विच जीव जांदा है, गुरु इसनू बारी सिमरन भी दिंदे है, जेड़ा उन्हां दा खुद अपना कमाया हुंदा है, और किस तरह अभ्यास दे वक्त सब ससंगियां नूं समझाउंदे है किस तरह तुसी सिमरन जेड़ा है ये लगातार करो, दोनों अखां दे दरमियान तीसरे तिल ते एकाग्र तुसी हो। जदों असीं तीसरे तिल ते जाने हैं सानू काफ़ी हौसला हो जाता है, विषय बकारां दा जोर सच पुछो तां तीसरे तिल ते एकाग्र होने वाली घटना शुरू हो जाता है। जदों स्थूल पड़दा लौने हैं तो स्थूल जिहड़े दुनिया दे भोग है ये सानू परेशान नहीं कर देंगे, अगे सूक्ष्म है इस तो भी ज्यादा जोर पाउंदे है, अगे कारण है और उत्थे भी मन इंद्रियां कारण हन, और जदों असीं पार ब्रह्म दे विच जाने हैं आत्मा तो सारे पर्दे ला लैने हैं, फिर सानू अपने आप की पहचान होंदी है। उत्थे मैं दसदा हुंदा किस तरह लिंग भेद भी उतो नीचे नीचे ही है, उत्थे ना कोई औरत है ना कोई मर्द है और ना कोई मजरी तस्व है, उस जगह उत्थे आत्मा ही आत्मा है। उत्थे जाके इन्हू अपने आप की समझ आउंदी है कि मैं आत्मा है, मैं उस सतपुरुष की बच्ची है, मेरे और इहदे विच कोई भिन्न भेद नहीं, जिस तरह समुंदर और नदी का कोई भिन्न भेद नहीं हुंदा, वह भी पानी हुंदा है, वह भी पानी हुंदी है।
Now lovingly he tells us that when any jiva goes to the feet of the perfect master, first of all the master showers his grace upon that jiva and gives him the simran, that simran which he himself has earned, which he himself has meditated upon and which he himself has perfected. So when the master gives us that simran and he tells us lovingly at the time of the initiation, all the initiates are told that how we have to do the simran, keeping our attention at the eye center. So when we keep our attention fixed at the eye center and when we go on doing the simran given to us by the master, then gradually the pressure of the worldly pleasures go on reducing. In fact, as soon as we start remaining at the eye center by doing the simran, the pressure of the worldly pleasures, the pressure of the passions go on reducing. And when we are successful in removing the physical cover from our soul, then we get rid of, we become free of the physical form of the lust, anger, greed, attachment and egoism. And then when we go beyond the physical plane, when after removing the physical cover from our soul, when we go in the astral plane, there also we have to fight with the astral form of the passions, and they are present over there in much more force than they are present in the physical form. But when we are able to go beyond that and when we go in the causal plane, there also we have to fight with the mind and the organs of senses, because they are present there in the causal form. But when we remove that cover also from our soul, when we become free from the causal covers, and then when we go in the parabrahm, then all these pleasures, all these passions, all these vices, they don't bother us anymore, because they do not exist over there. And after that we realize that we are not the bodies, we are the souls. I have often said that how when we reach parabrahm, even the difference of the gender is finished over there, because over there it is only the soul, neither anyone is man over there nor anyone is woman over there, and one does not even know whether one is black or white there, or one belongs to this or that country, because over there it is only one soul. So when the master gives us the simran and when he tells us to do the simran, and when we go on doing the simran according to the instructions of the master, and after removing all these covers from our soul, when we reach the parabrahm, then we are able to realize our own selves, and then we come to realize that who we are and what the master is, then master is and what he has given to us.
ਅਰਦ ਔਰਦ ਵਿੱਚ ਲਗਨ ਲਗੀ ਹੈ, ਸ਼ਕਿਓ ਰੂਪ ਨੇ ਜਾਤ ਬਖਾਨਾ। ਕਹੇ ਕਬੀਰ ਸੁਨੋ ਪਾਈ ਸਾਧੋ, उलट आप में आप समान।
कबीर साहब ने सारा शब्द कह के बड़े प्यार नाल सानू दस्या है कि जिस चीज दी साडी आत्मा नू प्यास है, भुख है, वो अमृत भी नाम दा सानू अंदरों ही मिलेगा। जिस परमात्मा दी सानू जन्मा जन्मात्रा तो खोज है, वो भी सानू शरीर दे विच्चों ही मिलेगा।
After saying the whole hymn, Kabir Sahib lovingly tells us that the food for which our soul is hungry, the water for which our soul is thirsty, that nectar we will receive it in our body, and God Almighty for whom we are searching since ages and ages, and we have been separated from Him, we will realize Him, we will get Him only from within our body.
लेकिन साड़ी कबीर साहब हालत दसदे है, वस्तु कहीं ढूंढे कहीं कह बिदा आवे हाथ, कहे कबीर तब पाईए जद भेदी लीजे साथ।
But Kabir Sahib describes our condition. He says that the thing is lost somewhere, but we are searching for it somewhere else. How can we get that thing back? We will receive that thing back only if we take someone who knows that where that place, where that thing is. If we take someone's help, only then we will be able to trace that lost thing.
किसे दी कोई वस्तु सी आश कर दे अंदर गुम हो गई, सड़क दे उते लाइट दे उते आके उस दी ओ खोज करदा है। किसे नंगड़ वाले ने पुछया कि प्यारिया इत्थे रात नू तू की खोज करदा है, वो कहन लग्या कि मेरी खास एक वस्तु है, वो गुम हो गई है, घर अंदर अंधेरा है, इत्थे प्रकाश है। वो कहन लग्या देख भई तू उत्थे भी प्रकाश पैदा कर सकदा है, तू जिदे अंदर प्रकाश प्रगट है तू ओदे कोल जाता सी, वस्तु तेन उथों ही मिलूगी जदो मिलेगी, जदो इत्थे वस्तु ही नहीं पवे तू जिन्ना मर्जी प्रकाश होर भी कर ला तेन किस तरह मिलेगी। इसे तरह ओ परमात्मा तो साडे शरीर देह दे अंदर है, लेकिन बाहर दिसे चानना दिल अंधेरी रात, असी की है बाहर तो सानू प्रकाश दिसदा है, अंदर असी जो प्रकाश जिहड़ा के गुरु नानक ने कहा सी नाम जपत कोट सूर उजारा बिनसे परम अंधेरा, एक नी अनेका सूरजा जिन्ना प्रकाश हर व्यक्ति दे अंदर है, लेकिन वो भरम दे पर्दे पिछे छिपिया होया है।
Someone lost something in his home, and instead of looking for it in his home, he went outside on the street where it was illuminated, where there was a lot of light, and he started looking for that thing over there. Another person came by there and asked him that what he was looking for and where he had lost it. So he said, well, I have lost something very important, very valuable in my home, but in my home there is darkness and here it is light, so that is why I am looking for it over here. So that person told him, well, how can you expect to get something which is lost in your home if you are looking for it here in the street? No matter how bright this place is, no matter how much light is over here, but since your thing is lost in your home, you will find it only if you will search for it in your home. And as far as the light is concerned, you can take this light to your home, you can manifest that light in your home, and in that light you should search for that thing. In the same way, at least first you go to that person, that master who has manifested that light in his within, and he will teach you, he will make that light manifest in your within, and then you will be able to find the thing, you will be able to search for the thing which is lost, because that thing is lost in your own self, in your own within. But what is our condition? We see that it is light outside, but in our within, in our home, it is deep darkness. Guru Nanak Sahib also said that by doing the meditation of the Naam, millions and trillions of sun rise up, and there is immense amount of light and radiance in our within. So when we do the meditation of the Naam, our within becomes bright, our within becomes illuminated with the radiance of the Naam, and then with the grace of the Master we are able to find that lost God Almighty who is present within us.